So for any new project, especially the new Age of Sigmar stuff, which a lot of it is brand new stuff, we spend a lot of time concepting and doing different color tests and trying out different things and trying to really evoke the narrative and the feel of the sculpture of the miniatures. That's a process that sometimes takes weeks or even months sometimes to go through different stages, and we'll do loads of different tests, and then we'll whittle it down to our favorites, and then we'll go even further.
So when doing the instructional video for this Idoneth Deepkin range, we had one big model to pick, which was the Levidon. Now there's two colours to pick from. There was the green big floating one that the army painting team did, but there's also the orange one. We went for the green one because it was just a little bit easier to show how to get all those cool textures, whether that's on the scales of the beast or on the shell of the beast, and also the howder as well. So we use that because it'll be more accessible to many people to paint. I think it's my funnest model I've painted so far for all these videos, just because there's so many different textures to pick out from, because you've got the howder, you've got the crew, and then you've got the big floating beast that just looks really gnarly and scary.
My favourite part of the new Idoneth Deepkin range is the new Fangmora eels. I think they're a fantastic addition, and just love the fact that they open themselves up for all sorts of patterning, coloration and everything.
My favourite part of the Idoneth Deepkin is the choice of colour you can give to all the beasts and the steeds that all the Achaeans are riding. So there's just so much. So the book has loads of ideas that you can draw from, whether that's the pale albino skin with like the red mottling on the top, but you can literally do anything you want. There's so many colours. It doesn't have to be brown horses, it can be anything. And again, just look at nature, look at all the things you can see on the internet, just look at any kind of aquatic beast that's out there and just draw upon that as inspiration.
So if you're planning on painting some Idoneth Deepkin yourself, I would probably suggest that you start off with the Enclave and the Enclave colours and figure out what the armor and the cloth and all of these things will be. So you have your army identity locked in, and then from there you can find colors for the beasts and the surrounding elements.
So a great tip for painting your thrall skin is to paint the skin iron rack skin, followed by Drakenhof nightshade mixed with Larmium medium shade. This will allow the shade to settle into the recesses without settling too much on the surface, and then you follow that by a layer of Deepkin flesh.
One of my favourite parts of the army as a whole is like how the background and the painting and the sculpture all comes together to give this really strong and deep background to this army. So you got like the difference between the Namarti and the Achaeans and the Isharan, and all this wealth of knowledge that you really feel that is a real race of elves that exist, and they've got like all this hierarchy and stuff, and how that then relates to both how they're sculpted differently and then also how you can paint them differently. I think it's come together really cool.